In Sumatra, wild tigers are in danger of being wiped out by poaching. So this breeding program in Indonesia is absolutely vital. And Australia Zoo has the privilege of raising three gorgeous new Sumatran tiger cubs. Tigers in the wild are in a lot of trouble and they need our help.
Once upon a time, deep in the jungle, there was a girl who lived in a tree.
That's why they called her.
Where, up in the jungle girl. Where, princess of the animal world. The croc hunter taught her, now his only daughter.
Brazil. And you too, Squeeze. Now we're off to Jakarta to look at some Sumatran tigers. They're highly endangered.
There are only a few hundred left in the wild. And at Australia Zoo, we have a tiger breeding program to help protect the future genetics of the species.
Thanks to the Indonesian government and Taman Safari Park, we've been given three precious Sumatra cubs. Indonesia's capital city, Jakarta, has almost 10 million people and dozens of the world's most endangered species of tiger at the Taman Safari Park. Most of these Sumatran tigers wouldn't be alive if they hadn't been rescued and saved for this successful breeding program. For the first time in nearly 30 years, Indonesia is letting three Sumatran tiger cubs out of the country. We're here to pick them up and take them home for our own breeding program at Australia Zoo. What a great honour. People are expanding their farms into tiger country, and that means serious conflict. A lot of these animals were part of the problem.
Usually it's not the tiger's fault. These first two that you see here were responsible for killing people. Most likely because their habitat is so diminished they've come into populated areas. Usually the tiger is the loser and has to be destroyed. But here, they're able to live, to breed, to continue the species. This fellow here is the father of the tiger cubs coming to Australia Zoo. Those cubs are so important because the mother tiger was from the wild. After she had killed someone, she became part of the endangered species breeding program. And the reality is, there's no safe place to put tigers back into the wild. Their best bet is going back into national parks. So at Australia Zoo, we're going to participate with these wonderful, purebred Sumatran tigers to help keep them for generations to come.
Get the chance to handle a big captive tiger, they sort of, let's just say, find small children interesting. But at the Bali Safari Park, I finally got my wish. There's another breeding program at the Bali Safari Park where we got to see some very rare tigers. These gorgeous white Sumatran tigers are a freak of nature. White tigers can't hide properly when they're sneaking up on prey, so they have a tough life in the wild. But they breed well and they thrive in captivity. One of them will be my very first time close to a large tiger.
Isn't this little bloke absolutely beautiful? Now, he's a white tiger, which is sort of a loose system. You can see he's got really, really blue eyes. What an incredible animal. Even at this size, you can feel how strong they are and the bulk of their... Look at the paws.
Oh, I'm sorry.
He's like, don't touch my paws. An absolutely amazing animal, and one we've really got to save. We just cannot afford to lose these guys in the wild.
Wow, this is just great.
Beautiful.
Like all cats, this young tiger is playful, and he's caught his own reflection in the camera lens.
Jane from Tennessee wants to know what's the difference between lion and tiger cubs. Well, Jane, tigers are born with stripes that they keep for life, but lions are born with spots that they lose after a few months.
So this is a little girl lion cub, and she's 3 weeks old. And it's the mama lions that catch the food. Do you know what the daddy lions do? Daddy lions sit around with their big mane and their big muscles, and they look really tough, and they say, nobody mucks with my pride. And he keeps the pride safe while all the mama lions go out and get dinner. And that's how it works. So they work together as a family, as a pride. That's what makes them so successful. Lions, of course, are in trouble where they live. As more and more people move into areas, there's conflicts between lions and livestock. People will charge money to safari hunt a lion, but of course, when people hunt, they're different than the lions. They don't hunt the weak, the sick, the young, the old. They hunt the biggest, the best, the most genetically perfect animal. And that, of course, destroys lion populations. So the best way to protect lions is to give them somewhere safe to live. Yeah.
Sumatran tigers are very precious. The Indonesian government has not allowed any out of their country for over 27 years until now. This is a rare event and there's heaps of media interest. So Tamman has brought out some of their star attractions for the press call. Both of them are from endangered species. A naughty young Sumatran orangutan who was orphaned when his mum was killed. And a very cute Javan leopard.
Don't you love him?
I love his little itchy tummy. He's got this itchy tummy.
Sumatran orangutans are critically endangered, partly because they're so gorgeous. Hunters kill their mothers so they can steal the babies for pets. They don't even know how many Javan leopards are left because they hardly see them anymore. They're being hunted for their skins. They're both the perfect size for playing with my brother Robert, who thinks he's a baby orangutan too.
Crikey!
Did you know the Sumatran tiger is the smallest tiger species in the world?
Just ahead, we meet our new cubs for the first time.
For their body parts, medicine, and trophies is making them endangered in the wild. We really need to help them.
These preserved bodies are not victims of the wildlife trade. They're being kept for educational reasons to help stop the trade.
Here at the Tamman Safari Park, all of these animals have died from natural causes, so they still have a purpose. They teach other people about how we can't keep poaching animals. People are poaching them out in the wild, and it's really, really sad. They're killing everything from crocs to tigers to elephants to you name it. They've killed it, you know, it's really, really sad. We have to stop this. People will kill them for their body parts, like for their teeth, their claws, their skin. It's awful. By catching the poacher, that won't solve anything. We need to stop the demand. So when the buying stops, the killing can too. Baby tigers are a handful every minute they're awake. The time has finally come for us to meet our three baby Sumatran tiger cubs. I am so excited.
It's a typical rainy day in tropical Jakarta. Our new tiger cubs are living in an apartment with Bruce and Jeff, the big cat keepers from Australia Zoo. They've been with the babies for 6 weeks, ever since they were born. They comfort them, play with them, and mother them, so they create a strong family bond. They've already got strong teeth and sharp claws, and they get stuck into everything. With baby tigers, it's play, 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 bite, 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 claw, claw, claw.
You get that camera, you kill it! You kill it, sweetie!
Have a look how beautiful her stripes are. But the funny thing is, did you
her stripes are on her skin as well. She's the most beautiful thing in the world. I love Sumatran tigers.
With three tigers and two handlers, my mum helps when it's time to leave. It's going to be 20 hours, starting with a long trip to the airport and ending with a two-hour drive to Australia Zoo. In between, there's a ton of paperwork, lots of waiting, and a very long flight.
Long journey, about 9 hours, so you ready for it, guys?
Crikey!
Did you know there's only about 400 Sumatran tigers left in the wild?
The flight from Jakarta to Australia Zoo is going to take a whole 9 hours. A big adventure for our three small tigers and a lot of organisation for all of us.
Goodbye, thank you. We'll see you in Australia. Thank you very much.
We'll see you in Australia.
Thank you so much.
Taramakasi.
Nothing is too good for our precious babies. A police escort all the way to make sure we bypass traffic jams and catch the flight on time. Now this is perfect. They checked in the cubs exactly the same as if they were people. We even get into the first class lounge with nothing but a pink blanket between the three tigers and the rest of the traveling world.
Well done.
And they're quiet. No one would ever know there were tigers in there.
They're all in the same box, together like a normal tiger family. Even though they're being really good, they're bored. And the other people in the lounge must be starting to wonder about all the growling.
Next time we'll have to get them first class seats.
Won't we, Robin?
Mm-hmm. I think so.
We kind of took over the airport. Parking, checking in, customs, security, hospitality. Everyone just opened up for the tigers. They were even allowed out of their box to play in the lounge. We kept them hidden behind some chairs, even though Robert wanted to let them out.
Go through there, go right there.
That'd be exciting.
Tiger cubs just want to play all the time. And they don't like being apart from the people they've been with ever since they were born. They're going to spend the rest of their lives with Australia Zoo's big cat handlers, Bruce and Jeff. They already think Bruce is their mother, and that's just what we want. Next, Sumatran tigers on a plane to Australia.
So they don't have to be alone in the cargo hold.
When we were figuring out how to bring the tigers home, we decided we just couldn't put them in a dark cargo hold like most animals. These little fellas had never been alone before in their short lives. And the airlines couldn't carry them in the passenger cabin. Too many rules and regulations. So there was only one thing to do. We chartered their own jet.
With their own private jet, the first class airport lounge, and their very own brand new sleeping compartment, I think our cubs are off to a flying start.
They're getting agitated with all of the moving. Good thing we hired our own plane.
Look at that big box. I like that so much better.
So far, our two girls and one boy tiger have been kept in a box built for one big dog. But now they're being moved into a family-sized crate made at Australia Zoo just for these VITs, very important tigers. And each cub gets loving attention from our big cat handlers.
You're being so...
Aren't they gorgeous? They're all going in one transport box, and we're hoping they'll play together and comfort each other for the long flight back to Australia. When they're little like this, tigers love being together. But in the wild, adult tigers are loners, and they only get together when it's time to start a family. It's like a normal flight, cabin crew to take care of us, and two pilots in the cockpit. This is not a small private jet. It's a full-size 100-seat airliner, just for 5 people and 3 precious tigers. Just as well we have our own plane. I'd hate to think what they'd be like if we let them go into the cargo hold of a normal flight. It's now very late, and our babies settle down for a good night's sleep. Or at least we hope so, but tiger cubs don't work that way. We humans need heaps of sleep right through the night, but young tigers are on the go almost all the time. They sleep or rest for an hour or two between bursts of activity.
Now that the sun's coming up, they're starting to wake up. And they're just waking up cranky, like a lot of little kids.
They're worn out of the carry box so they can play. They also want attention from their handlers. And more than that, they're hungry. They want breakfast. At this age, we have to bottle feed them 4 times a day, and that's every 6 hours. Bruce is doing everything a tiger mum would do. He plays games to encourage their natural instincts, and he even disciplines them when they're naughty. The flight crew have never seen anything like this before, and the tigers don't see many flight crews either. But they're going to meet new people all the time back at Australia Zoo.
They're a little bit upset because they want to get out and play. They don't understand why they're in this container. So we've thrown Bruce in with them to play with them until we land in Brisbane.
Luckily, we built a big travel crate because Bruce is going to be stuck in there for a few hours to make sure his babies don't get bored and stop misbehaving. This is just so exciting, flying into Brisbane and about to touch down in Australia with our gorgeous cargo. The flight has gone better than we could ever expect. We're all a bit tired, but the tigers are in great condition and they're really happy.
Coming up, our 3 gorgeous cubs arrive home at Australia Zoo.
Australia Zoo. This is the first time Sumatran tigers have flown into Brisbane, and you wouldn't believe the red tape. The tigers hate being away from people, and they're letting everyone know it. Dr. John from the Australian Wildlife Hospital is here from Australia Zoo to deal with forms, permits, and other paperwork. So many different approvals from so many different government departments, and then it's a 2-hour drive up to Australia Zoo. Home at last. Hope our little tigers are looking forward to this as much as we are.
Hello. Smile at the camera. That's all right.
They're happy to be out of the travel box for the last time.
What a huge journey. This is such a coup for Sumatran tigers, for Indonesia, and for Australia Zoo. It's a real point of pride. You made it. Good baby.
As well as being a new home, this is also a quarantine station where they'll live with the big cat keepers. It's really important to keep them tucked away from the animals in the main part of the zoo, just in case they've got an illness that hasn't shown up yet.
Congratulations. What a day. Way to go. This is exciting.
It's time for their first big health check at Australia Zoo. That gadget will detect a special microchip that's already been inserted just below the skin. We use them so we can identify every individual animal. Dr. John is checking every possible aspect of the baby tiger's health.
Doing a health check on the tiger cubs is really important when they first get here. They're going into a 30-day quarantine to make sure they don't have anything that might affect any other animals, particularly the other tigers. So Dr. John's going through and checking out heart, lungs, eyes, mouth, taking temperature, just an overall health check. What's tricky is doing this with a patient who is not terribly cooperative.
Baby tigers aren't the only ones to take a long flight when they're only a few weeks old. I know just what it's like. When I was first hatched, my mum and dad took me across Australia in an old aircraft.
What a sight! Lift off and we cover the first of almost 2,500 miles of adventure.
How you going, tiny little baby?
Woo, baby!
And my mum. And my mum.
This vintage World War II plane is a DC-3, over 50 years old and still going strong. And that's our old dog, Suey, first dog I ever knew and the best dog ever. We flew right across Australia from east to west, about the same distance as across the USA, my first big plane trip. Tiger cubs are now happily settled in their new home at Australia Zoo and growing rapidly every day.
Tigers in the wild are fighting a huge battle against habitat loss and poachers, putting their survival into the future on the line.
The one most important thing we can do to help tigers in the wild is not to buy any tiger products. We'll see you next time for more fun in the jungle. Bye!
Bye.
Australia Zoo now has 11 of these endangered big cats. Thanks for asking, Annette. These new tigers at Australia Zoo are only 4 weeks old, but they grow really quickly. 2 weeks can mean a big difference in size.
That noise that Bruce is making just kind of gets them used to you and, like, in a friendly way.
They're gorgeous, but clumsy.
What Bruce is doing by playing with them, like kissing them and hugging them, is he's establishing trying to be like their mother so that they can also get used to people and stuff like that.
These guys came to us from another zoo.
You can't go.
They're a great size for Robert to play with, and he just loves them as well. They're crossbreeds. Most of their family are Bengal tigers. Australia Zoo has 10 tiger handlers for 11 tigers. This one-on-one interaction means they totally bond with the keepers. It gives the tigers the best quality of life, and the public loves the interaction between humans and big cats.